Hey there, welcome back to Laura's Natural Life, and today we're talking about the dangers of scented candles and non-toxic home fragrance alternatives. I personally have never been a candle person, but I understand why you guys like them. They add a nice element to a room and they're beautiful and they make your home smell a way that you like and they can make nice gifts, but I would suggest that you save your money on them and save yourself a lot of toxic exposure. So I definitely would recommend that you don't use synthetic fragrance of any kind in your home, whether it be candles, plug-ins, reed diffusers, and that's just for home fragrance, but like anywhere in your house. But today, just I'm talking specifically about candles and alternatives because that's what I get the most questions on. So I just want to shed some light on what's happening with the scented candle and the problems with it. So the first biggest problem for me is the synthetic fragrance. You guys know I talk about this all the time. I have videos on it. I have a podcast on it. I talk about it in every video, but synthetic fragrance to me is public enemy number uno. It's in everything. The US doesn't require that companies disclose what they use in their fragrance cocktails. There's 3,100 chemicals that they can choose from to mix up to create a specific scent. Many of those chemicals have never been tested for safety. Some of them are considered toxic waste by the EPA and have specific regulations on how to dispose of those chemicals, including like gloves and goggles and suits and whatnot. They include parabens and phthalates, and they're just like bad. They're really bad chemicals. So if you can get those out of your home, the better. That's number one. Now, issue number two with candles is what the wax is made out of. Most candles are made of paraffin wax, and paraffin is a petroleum waste product. And in order to get it to become a wax, the petroleum to be a wax, it has to be treated chemically, including bleached. And the wax itself, especially when burned, releases chemicals including benzene and toluene, both of which are pretty highly carcinogenic, and they're released in diesel fumes. Some studies show that in terms of breathing in that quality of air could be as bad as like secondhand smoke. So problem number three is the wick, what the wick is made out of. Most candles in America, it looks like, are using some sort of paper wick, but some are still using a lead wick. Lead is a heavy metal and it can release that into the air as well. And we don't need any more heavy metal exposure than we're getting. That affects our neurological system as well as a bunch of other things. So definitely check out what the wick is made out of as well. So one other issue could be artificial dyes using to dye the candle wax to a specific color. Now, if you want to use a candle, I do have an option for you. The only candle brand that I would trust is Woodlot. So Woodlot is free of petroleum, phthalate, synthetic fragrance, and GMOs. So these are actually made with a coconut wax and pure essential oils. So they're also really beautiful, handmade, and non-toxic. So these are the only store-bought candles that I feel comfortable with. I still don't know that I believe that burning an essential oil is safe. I just kind of feel like essential oils at a high heat could turn carcinogenic, possibly. I guess I don't have enough research to back that up, but I'm not convinced that it's totally safe to burn an essential oil. But if you love a candle and you want a non-toxic option, Woodlot is the option that I would recommend to you and I would choose and feel comfortable with using and gifting. Now, the other option here is I will link a candle, homemade DIY candle recipe that I found on Pinterest, and where you can buy coconut wax. So soy wax I would probably avoid as well, just because it's GMO, but you know, do your own research and see what you think about it. And then the other wax option is beeswax, and beeswax is actually really good for your air quality. It has like an ion exchange and helps like just create a healthier air, and beeswax and the propolis in beeswax is really great for air quality as well. So beeswax is a great option, but it does smell like beeswax. So keep that in mind. And just keep in mind, if you want a candle that has scent, to use a pure essential oil, or see if you can wean off the scent. That would definitely be my tip number one. So let me know if you guys have any questions down below about candles or non-toxic home fragrance options. I'd be happy to answer them for you or direct you somewhere where you can get your answer. And thank you guys so much for watching. Remember to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.